And we have another special Whoop guest chef to join Mark in the Becco kitchen. Morning, hey, Jamie. How are you?
Good.
From Judge Bow.
Yes.
And Mark, good to see you back here again.
Morning. Yeah. How are you?
Just about didn't make it, did you?
No, yeah. Auckland traffic.
Jamie and I had it. We had it under control, Mark. How about you excited about today's recipe?
Yeah, really excited. So classic Chinese recipe, sweet and sour chicken. Obviously in the Whoop bag, it's already made for you, so it's really fast, but we're going to show you the secrets of how to make it, and we've got all the ingredients here a little bit later on.
And Jamie, what's the secret to a good sweet and sour chicken?
Well, it's going
to
be sweet and it's going to be sour.
Oh, nice.
And it's going to have chicken.
It's going to have chicken. We have the right man for the job. Great to have you with us in the Becco kitchen for another Whoop Wednesday, my favourite day of the week, Whoop Wednesday. And this day we are making oven-baked sweet and sour chicken with stir-fried vegetables on a sticky jasmine rice. Thanks to guest chef Jamie Johnson from Judge Bow. How are you, Jamie?
Yeah, I'm good, mate.
Okay, now you are the sauce guru, so clearly the sauce is very important here, but not only just the sauce, we've got to get all the other elements right. And for Whoop Wednesday, as a guest chef, geez, they have some great chefs for Whoop Wednesday. You've decided to bring us this recipe, which Mark, I hope, is going to cook for us.
Yeah.
Well, no, you're not going to do it.
Yeah, it's a day off for me. Mark's on the chicken at the moment, so we decided not to go for a deep fried kind of thing, so we wanted it baked and really light and zesty and yummy, full of all the spices and flavours. But just to give people an idea that you can still get those flavours but via ovening as opposed to not deep frying at home.
Nice, yes, because a lot of us are familiar with sweet and sour chicken from the takeaways, but this is a much healthier, tastier version. And, of course, you can do it all at home yourself. And now, most of it's all done for you when you get your Whoop box, but we're going to make it from scratch. So what are you going to do for us today, Jamie?
OK, I'm going to make our coating. So instead of making a typical batter where we deep fry, we're actually doing like a corn flour crumb to go on the chicken. So we've got corn flour in there.
Yeah.
And then we've got a little bit of baking powder, and that helps it go really crispy.
Nice, we like crispy.
And kind of tenderizes the chicken, so you get that kind of cool mouthfeel.
Okay, cool.
And then we're using a bit of five spice, and we make our own. So we, but you'll get that in the packet. And we've been retailing it up at Catalina Bay Farmers Market every Saturday and Sunday.
Brilliant.
So you can actually buy that off us and some of our food.
Oh, nice.
Right there. So our five spice smells like really cool.
Oh, yeah, that
really
smells
toasted,
good.
Really toasted, really fresh and really yum.
Oh, so this is a good way to sample it through the Wednesday series, isn't it? So if you like this spice, then you can head to where? The
Catalina Bay Farmers Market up in Hobsonville Point.
Yeah, that's really popular at the moment.
Yeah, you can grab a coffee, some produce, get some Judge Bow Bow, which is probably the most important thing.
Yes.
So we're just doing a light coat like that.
Yeah.
And that'll just help it go nice and crispy. And then Mark's on the veggies. So we've gone for the nice typical veg that you'll get in your sweet and sour.
Yes.
So we've got capsicum, red onion and broccoli, you know, greens, reds, all those really nice colours and just crunchies. So everything's going to be stir-fried real quick.
Nice.
So it's, you know, crunchy, and then the chicken's going to be crispy on top. Then we've got the beautiful sauce to sort of like go all the way through it.
When you're playing around with a sweet and sour chicken, what is it that you're looking for the most when it comes to creating, a good recipe?
Well, I mean, for me, like
sweet and sour.
Yeah, it's got to be sweet and it's got to be sour. I told you this. I like it heavily based on veg. You know, like I love the veg in there because I want the crunch from the veggies, and then you want to search for the meat through it as well, you know, so you've got a bit of everything.
Nice.
So you can kind of appease everyone. But the sauce is going to be like...
I should do something.
A little wee bit, yeah.
Like that?
Yeah, there, that'll do, yeah. So I'm going to chuck in the onion to start with. So I'm going to just turn that up onto a high heat. So again, giving it a really good fry. So we've got a bit of noise there, so that means we're doing our job properly.
Okay, good tip.
But it's really fast, isn't it? You don't want to cook it so much that it softens. You want that crunch from there.
Yeah, and all the veg is nice and chunky, so it's cooked on the outside, but it still remains crunchy and fresh.
Okay, so keep them about this size. So Mark's done a good job of divvying them up. Yeah. Are you a sweet and sour chicken fan, Mark?
Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. And there's, you know, for one dish which is sweet and sour, like there's so many different ways of actually doing it.
Right.
You know, like doing it like this, baking it, you know, not deep frying it, different meats, different vegetables. You know, you can really sort of customise it. It's great.
Nice.
And then
I guess you could do a vegetarian version too, couldn't you?
Oh, you could. You could do it with aubergine.
Yes.
When they're cheap. And even do it with tofu. It's really, really quick, and you can just toss it together. And tofu is actually probably quicker than the meat. And then we're going to This whole point in the stir fry is to show off, eh?
Yeah.
That's the only reason I...
Let my cup go.
Mark's taught me how to do this. Okay, here we go. Oh, I'm not as good as you, Jamie.
It's all in the wrist.
Yeah.
Is it? Oh,
there
we are.
Oh, yeah, there we go. And that is the fun you can have with a Whoop dish, which you will get delivered to your home. So make sure you check them out, whoop.co.nz. We're going to come back and see the second part of this. Things are starting to smell incredible here. And Mark and Jamie, we need to finish off our Whoop Wednesday dish, which hopefully is going to turn out looking like this. I was just having a little look at the back. It takes 20 minutes when you get it at home, and everything's colour-coded. So when you get your Whoop box at home, you just look for everything that's got the yellow sticker and then you get it ready, just like we've got in front of us here. We're making it from scratch today. The vegetables smell incredible already, and we haven't even put the sauce on. And oven baked chicken, a bit healthier,
than deep fried. Nice. So just make sure you've got an even coating on it, give it a little bit of room on the tray, and then you're going to pop it in an oven about 180 degrees for about 15 minutes till the chicken's cooked. Gives you time to get the rest of the dish ready.
Nice. Okay, so we're going to concentrate on the sauce now.
Yeah, that's my port, the sauce.
Sauce king.
Yeah, it's all about sauce.
No pressure.
Yeah. Oh, no pressure, yeah. Okay. Yeah, so sweet and sour sauce. It's pretty much a sauce made of loads of other sauces.
Okay.
And depending on whose grandma you speak to, she probably does it a different way. So we've got a bit of ketchup, which is one of the main ingredients, and who doesn't love ketchup? So we've got some of that in there, and then we've gone for apricot. So we've got like a pureed apricot in here as well, which adds a nice sort of like fruity element to it.
Okay, all that. Yep, nice.
Oyster sauce, which is cracking. We love that oyster sauce.
Yeah.
That gives it that umami, that umami flavour. So that's what we're looking for.
Nice.
So that.
Who taught you how to cook?
Me.
Yeah. What got you into it?
Well, my art teacher. He told me I was crap at art. So. And then my mum said, you have to either go work for your dad in the shoe shop. And I was like, after watching my two older brothers work for him, I decided I didn't want to. And then I decided to do, decided to study cooking. And then it only took sort of like 2 or 3 years for me to kind of get into it and realise that I quite liked it. And then from there, I just stuck at it, really. And then the more places I worked at, the new stuff I'd learn. And yeah,
brilliant.
That was it. And then the Chinese thing came through because like, myself and Deb met, and she had cooked some really cool dishes at home, and I was like, oh, why can't you get that out, you know?
Right.
So, and then we decided to make our lives hard by making our own steam buns. So,
And the rest is history.
And the rest is history,
yes.
Yeah,
so. And, you know, she's in the audience with us today, just keeping an eye on you, I think.
Yeah, talking about phones.
Here we go. She didn't watch that clip earlier, did she? Okay, so you finished off the sauce. While we were talking, you put a little bit of
soy sauce.
Yes.
And then we've got rice wine for the acid.
Okay.
Rice wine vinegar, sorry.
Yep.
And the secret ingredient is Worcestershire sauce.
Ah, there you go.
Even though I can't pronounce it.
So what sort of heat do you keep it on?
So we're going to bring it to the boil and bring all those things to a bubble.
Okay.
And then we add our pineapple.
Nice.
And we're just going to blitz it.
Oh, yeah, great.
Blitz it all together.
And because you've got all, like, finished sauces already, you're just going to bring it up. You don't want to start cooking this for, like, you know, hours and hours. You're going to lose all those flavours. So it's a really, really fast sauce.
So you're not reducing it or anything,
just
warming it up.
It'll be nice and sweet. And as soon as it's hot, blitz it together.
So blitz it together, you get a nice sort of thick, beautiful, sweet and sour sauce. Mm. And then we toss it over the vegetables.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the chicken,
And then the chicken's, once the chicken's cooked and crispy, toss it all through, and then it's ready to serve. And you've just got some normal rice there to serve with it.
Yeah, some jasmine rice,
and it's good to go.
Easy as that, and if you want to do it at home, it's a lot easy to just go to whoop.co.nz, because rather than making your sweet and sour sauce, it just comes in a little container like this. You don't have to be blitzing anything. It's going to be delicious. So good to have you back on the cafe.
Thank you so much.
See you at the farmer's market in Hobsonville. That would be awesome. And if you'd like to get a Whoop foodie box and get everything to make this dish without any of the preparation or fuss, just head along to whoop.co.nz, and we have your chance to win a Whoop foodie box on our Facebook page right now. It's very popular, so get entering, okay? Now, look at what we have in front of us. Our delicious sweet and sour chicken, which you can have delivered this Sunday if you head along to whoop.co.nz. Jamie, thank you so much.
All right, totally welcome.